Hello, we are the CMS Section 508 program team. We have put together a series of videos that provide useful information and instruction on making CMS information technology products and services accessible to all who seek them. Section 508 is important for everyone at CMS, and it's a federal law. The title of this videocast is Important Steps in the CMS Software Application Testing Process, an instructional video for business owners and software application developers. If you are developing software for use by CMS beneficiaries and employees, that software must be Section 508 compliant. CMS conducts testing for Section 508 compliance because we want all CMS customers, as well as our CMS coworkers, to have equal access to information and applications needed to utilize CMS services or to conduct CMS-related business. For software applications, CMS Section 508 compliance applies to any new software or web-based application being developed, as well as any commercial off-the-shelf product and any existing CMS applications with new user interface changes. If you are a business owner and you have a new software application, you will first send a request through the CMS IT service desk. From there, it moves to both functional testing and Section 508 testing. For functional testing, the software or application is tested for its functionality to see if it meets the desired technical specifications and system requirements at CMS. For Section 508 testing, the requester will receive an email from the CMS 508 Accessibility Validation Testing Team. This email will include a test plan and a link to the Voluntary Product Accessibility Template, also known as the VPAT. The VPAT can be found on the Information Technology Industry Council website at itic.org or by visiting the CMS XLC Artifacts and Template section on cms.gov. The VPAT, shown here, includes instructions and must be completed in full. Incomplete forms will delay the testing and approval process. What is testing? Testing consists of a two-hour WebEx call, and it is important that everyone on your team is invited to the call, especially the software developers and any other technical stakeholders. If no one is able to answer questions about coding or other technical issues during this call, this will result in a delay in the testing and approval process. How do we test for CMS Section 508 compliance? Along with some automated testing tools, we use a manual desk-side testing methodology. An important part of the testing will determine if your application can be utilized by someone who is visually impaired. After testing is complete, your software application will receive a score. If your score is 100%, CMS considers the application to be Section 508 compliant and needs no further review. If your score is 99% or below, then remediation is required. For scores of 76 to 99%, the application is ready to go live, but some remediation and a remediation plan is required for any outstanding issues. However, if the score is 75% or below, the application cannot go live, and an approved remediation plan is required before the application can move forward. If your software is being developed using Agile methodology, or if you have other special development details, the CMS Section 508 team will work with you to determine an appropriate remediation schedule to fit your plan. Let's summarize the details of the CMS software application testing process. Section 508 compliance makes your application accessible to CMS beneficiaries and employees. The Voluntary Product Accessibility Template, or VPAT, must be completed in full. Follow the VPAT instructions and leave no sections blank. Please include your developers on the testing call to answer any technical questions. Your application will be scored, and remediation is needed if the score is less than 100%. If your application is scored between 76% and 99%, it may be allowed to go live. However, an approved remediation plan is required, and remediation activities must be completed. If your score is 75% or less, the application cannot go live without remediation. Thank you for taking the time to view and or listen to this video. For more details about CMS 508 compliance for software applications and the VPAT, please use this resource list. On the web, go to cms.gov, www.cms.gov/research-data-and-systems/cms-information-technology/section508/accessibility_validation.html. You may also email us at cms_section508@cms.hhs.gov or continue to view other videos in this Section 508 videocast series.